Sir Handel is an entitled engine. He acts as if hard work was beneath him and that he was above it all. His repeated offenses had a way of gripping the mind as the other engines went about their work. What made Sir Handel the way he was? And would he ever learn his lesson? It was a difficult code to crack, even for the ones that knew him best.
Stupid whistle, stupid cab bolt, stupid whistle chain, stupid A4 steak sauce whistle. Why is everything my fault? It's not fair. I mean, people say I grumble almost as much as Duncan, but Duncan's the real grumble. I am just treated unfairly. Everything is so stupid.
He's certainly been stuck up lately.
He has, and I'll tell you why. It's that new name of his. He did nothing to earn such a title.
What did you do to earn your title?
Humph!
I was only asking.
You make a fair point. Perhaps I hadn't earned my title before I received it, but I lived up to it. I've yet to see Sir Handel do the same.
Wasn't Sir Handel renamed in honor of the railway's first owner?
He was. Our owner was a remarkable man. He deserved to have an engine bear his name. But I have to admit, it is quite a name for Sir Handel to live up to.
He'd better get started, or he might get his wings clipped.
And not a moment too soon.
Excuse me?
You've been no help.
Why, whatever do you mean? Okay, perhaps I did eavesdrop a little, but I couldn't agree more with what's been said about that Sir Handel. Why, the thought of a fancy name stoking an engine's ego rattles me to my core.
But you're part of the problem. He looks up to you, and whenever you fill his funnel with nonsense, we're the ones that have to deal with him.
Oh, goodness me! I had no idea the little railway held me in such high esteem. I'll certainly be more mindful in the future.
Everything he said sounded nice. So why do I feel so cross?
It's not always what you say, it's how you say it.
Thankfully, Gordon would have a humbling experience of his own. Somewhere down the line.
I'm going to be late! Steaming pistons! Who's that?